Welcome back to the Scale Builders Guild. Thanks again for watching. It's part two of the Vanquish Ripper Build Series. And I, for one, am very happy to be doing this second in the build series for the Ripper. This has been an amazingly fun truck to work on, and I'm really excited to be done and to get it out there and to have some fun with it. I built this with the intention of showing it off for the first time at Axial Fest 2018. This is the first time I think that I haven't been right down to the wire on all my builds for Axial Fest. So it's kind of nice to have a little bit of a relaxing week before the big trip. You knew I was gonna have to play with a chainsaw. It's mandatory. So let's dive right into it. There are a lot of things that I had intended on doing in part one that unfortunately just didn't really come to fruition. The biggest part, and I think you're seeing it right away, is that I did end up going with the bomber interior. Yes, I had lofty plans of making my own interior shell. I wanted to give it some depth. I wanted to put in full-size drivers, but realistically, I knew that it wasn't gonna happen. Mostly because there isn't really room in there once you get the dig system in, once you get the transmission mounted, once you get all the electronics. Not to worry though, I did put my twist on the bomber interior, painted it on the exterior to give it a flat look so it doesn't just scream Lexan, added some heads from BeetleLover on the Tamiya forums. James French casts these heads in resin, and the detail is incredible. You can get right in there and see the little lines and the crow's feet and the eyes. It's awesome. I cannot believe the amount of detail that goes into these things, and to me, it just adds another level of realism. They really make the interior shine, and having them there was a must-have, definitely. I painted and detailed the heads myself. James produces a great guide on how to paint, and for the purposes of these heads, I used Citadel paints, which you can pick up at Games Workshop. You may notice that the driver looks an awful lot like creepy Uncle Albert. I wonder if that's him. I also added my 3D printed GPS system. This is available on Shapeways. I think it adds a nice little bit of depth and some realism to an otherwise fairly flat interior. It also looks great with the antenna on the roof. I thought it was a nice addition and definitely gives it a bit more realism in that interior. On the back, you'll also notice another 3D printed part. Those are my Fox Racing inspired shock reservoirs. I used a little bit of Tamiya braided hose to make it look as if they attached to the shock. Just another little touch of realism, something that I can use to make it really my own. The spare is now a matching spare, Wrangler MTR 4.75 RC four-wheel drive tire. Excellent tread, excellent compound. It's a great looking tire, really happy to have them on there. You'll notice behind the KMC machetes, I've added some SuperShafty disc rotors. It was imperative to me to add another little touch of realism there, and these look awesome. I don't think I went over this in the first video, but the front lights are Q-Series rigids. Rather than just go with a white headlight, I added some tinted automotive film to give them that yellow tint look. It's just nice to do something a little bit different. I'm able to control all of those lights because I'm using a HEOK light controller. It's wired into the 3S battery system and allows me to use a fourth channel to turn them on and off on my DX5C. That way all the lights aren't on during the day, I can just flip them on with the flick of a switch. The cooling fan in the radiator runs all the time. Just thought it was best to get as much air flowing over that ESC as possible. On the hood, I've mounted the 3D printed hood scoops. They were printed at Shapeways as well. Normally they're included in the kit, but I think at the time the printer was down, so I didn't get them. I asked Josh if I could have the STL file and printed them myself. Now let's dive into some of the wiring. I spent an awful lot of time wrapping and wiring because I really wanted to make sure this was a clean build and didn't have a lot of wires sticking out or something that could get chewed up in the spur gear. It just made sense for me to spend as much time under the hood as I did outside. Got this cool looking braided wire wrap, and things are definitely cleaner under there than they were before. my friend Ryan Luna from R3 Designz built and printed some awesome accessories for the Ripper. He created these extra long, extra protective sliders for the bottom of the truck just to protect those aluminum panels and to give you a nice smooth surface to clear rocks. And he also printed some interior fenders for the front of the truck so you can't see all the way through. Definitely a must have for me. I don't like seeing wires and I like to make sure everything's as hidden and as realistic as possible. Running this truck is the Castle Mamba X and Slate Motor combo at 2850 kV. One thing I really like about the Mamba X system is that it allows you to adjust your drag brake on the fly from an auxiliary channel. It's a very cool feature and it's something that I've been playing with a lot. Sometimes it's nice to have a drag brake that holds really hard. Sometimes you want it to have a little bit of freewheeling. It's really great to just go in and adjust on the fly. Also, using the B-Link in this system, I have a lot of control from my telephone for a lot of the features of the Mamba X. Definitely something to check out and definitely something I would like to expand on in an upcoming video. Mechanically, the dig is in and functions beautifully. If you've never used a dig before, here's a quick demo on what's possible. Of course, you have four-wheel drive. You can also have a freewheeling rear, so if you wanted to use the front to just pull yourself up over an obstacle, that's what that's for. And additionally, you can lock that rear axle so it doesn't move at all. Makes for an excellent steering radius and can really get you out of some binds. There you have it, the Vanquish Ripper all done, ready to run. I'd like to thank Vanquish for putting out this truck. I think it's a fantastic piece of rolling art. I cannot wait to give it a scratch, a dent. I'm definitely gonna grab some running video of it while we're at Axial Fest. Definitely the place for it. If you enjoyed this build, I'd love to hear from you. Make sure to post in the comments below and like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Thanks so much for watching. See you again soon.